Welcome back to Let's Play World of Warcraft. This is part 7 of the series, and I have some excellent news. Recently, or in fact yesterday even, my account has been made into a producer account, so I can make videos longer than 15 minutes. That's right, so I don't have to worry about being too fast, too slow. I can say goodbye whenever I want. Being polite while in a group with others will get you invited back. I'm sure it will, but that depends. And we were floating in the water. Right. It's been a while since I've last played because my account subscription got cancelled and I had to buy a game card. So, we've completed all our quests, which is really excellent. So let's go hand them in. Let's swim! Shall I hand that one in? Yeah, I think I'll hand this one in. The Ravaged Caravan. Because he might have some more quests to do, and then we'll go around the world doing the other quests, and then we can hand these in and get the EXP off. I'm not sure if it's the best way to do it, but it's a way nonetheless, and I have news from the Wild Dev team for my 6th anniversary, so here we go. I think I've boosted my graphics, I'm not sure. I see a lot more foliage on the ground than last time, but might be just me. I've tried to record Fable crap. I'm dying! No, Mr. Cougar, you will not beat me at a game of wit. Because I will kill you. That's right. What's that? That's a 4.5 second cooldown. I thought that was instant. I might have missed. I think when you miss with spells, the cooldown doesn't sort of affect. Well, it doesn't with rogues anyway, like, you don't get energy loss. And I have no idea where I'm going. A big thank you to all my subscribers so far. Since I've started this Let's Play of World of Warcraft, I've got about 20 subscribers, and that's about 60% more than my original one, or my original 20, so big thanks to all you guys. Hi, Morin Cloud Striker. Even though you're not a striker, you're a stalker. Okay, so that's 630 experience. The Venture Company kills 7 Venture co-workers for Morin Cloud Stalker at Bloodhoof Village. Well, he's not really in Bloodhoof Village. He's sort of outside it. He's an outsider. And this is a beautiful new add-on in the Cataclysm. If there's a sort of mini-boss or boss in the game and there's a quest to kill him, it'll give you a nice little portrait of the little monster that you have to kill. I don't think you can zoom. No, you can't zoom in. It's just that picture. So, kill supervisor Fizz Sprocket and collect Fizz Sprocket's clipboard. Don't know why he wants a clipboard, but anyway, what's the reward for that? Okay, we get some sandals. Not that that helps, but anyway. Oh, we have to go up here. Oh dear, Jesus. I always hated these quests because when I created my first ever character, which was a Tauren, I did a quest that was to kill things in this cave, and I could never find the entrance. I outskirted the entire of Morgor, and I could still never find it, and I gave up, and I was like really sad, and then I quit WoW for like 10 minutes, and then I joined again. So yes, kind of sucks, but nonetheless, I'm planning to transfer one of my other characters, actually, from a Draenei priest to a goblin priest, seeing now I'm fully upgraded to Cataclysm and have been level. Oh crap, don't kill me, Mr. Cougar. What is it with cougars and me today? I mean, am I like a cougar magnet? I hope not, because that would suck. But anyway, so these are the Venture co-workers, as I pointed out in the last episode or video. We've just got to kill them, smash their brains in. That's right, and reap the rewards. Now, since I've been logged off for about 3 to 4 days, you'll notice my bar has turned from purple to blue. And that basically means it's rested experience, and I get twice as much until that much is full. So it's really easy, and certain people say when they reach level 70, they'll just stop their character for a few weeks and level up their character super fast, or twice as fast in that case. So what we're doing now is we're going into this cave here, and oh, there's another mini boss. Ooh, he has a silver dragon around his portrait. That, folks, means he's a rare monster and he drops more than average goods. So you might drop a nice green item, or in some cases in the higher level areas, a blue item, which means a rare. So let's kill him! Let's smash his huge brain in! Even though he's a... I think it's not a troll. He's a... something. He's a something, people! I don't know. I'm tired. Take that, Mr. Enforcer Emelgund. Yes. So let's see what he dropped. 1,000 experience just for killing him. That's insane. And he dropped a 6 salt bag. No use to us, so... awesome. They've got an anvil and a forge, and they're used for blacksmithing. So, yes, we have to go in here, I think. We have to go in here. Yes, there he is. It shows on the map now, which is really cool, on the mobs or the monsters that you have to kill. And there he is, so we can put a little moon in front of him. Because I've been drawing moons today in school, which is where I learn about biology and physics and chemistry and IT, which is ironically my best subject. Have that, Mr. Supervisor! Wow, 20 health increase. And I'm guessing I should stand out of the fire, because that would suck. Ah, the fire's gone, so I can loot his cold corpse. And we're done with both the quests now. How much EXP did we get from killing Supervisor Sprocket? Oh, exactly the same amount, which is a shame, really. If only the rare came back, Emelgund, because then we could farm him for a while, and that would be epic ponage. So let's return. I'm absolutely loving the music, by the way, the sort of jaunty carnival music. It fills me with enthusiasm. Oh, what a big boulder. Imagine if you got crushed by that. That would suck. Aha! I spit on you, Mr. Flatland Cougar, or a Mrs., or in some cases, transsexual cougars. So now, we're returning to hand in our quests. Our quests of glory! Careful not to attract any monster's attention. Oh, I attracted a swoop. A witty swoop. Or, not even witty enough, because it's dead. And I misunderstood the term wiry. I don't know why it's wiry, but I think witty would have been more appropriate, seeing how birds are witty in themselves. There's me rambling on about birds for no apparent reason. I please hope I'm going in the right direction. Do I need to collect that? No. Okay. Aha! I was going in the wrong direction. I'm going to take a sip of my juice. Ah! Nummy juice. I nom on its juicy goodness. So what do we get? We get 750 experience for that, and 1050 experience for that. Now, I don't feel the need for getting 6 armor. Or even 7 armor. I'm going to go for the Goblin Masher because it's worth a lot more copper. And there we go, a level 9! And you know what? Ooh, what's this? My holy power bar, whatever that means. So, he's got no more quest for us. You bad Torin, you Morin. So now we can go hand in our quest. In fact, I'll hearth because I can. Well, I haven't even got a cloak on. I can't do that right now! I can't do it while I'm hearthing! That sucks. Man, oh man, am I hyper today? Really suck if my microphone was off. So, yeah, now we can put our cloak on. And do we need this? No, we do not need that. Okay. We can sell everything else, which is absolutely brilliant. And there's a quest from Rule Eagle Totem. Whoever the hell she is. Okay, so we get 660 experience for that, and... ooh, some nice leggings. Legs of the long day. So now we need to collect 6 Stalker Claws and 6 Cougar Claws. Finally get our revenge on those ambiguous cougars. Ha-ha! Let's train Word of Glory. Consumes all holy power to heal a friendly target for 80 per charge of holy power. Whatever that means! Oh, and we get a nice little tutorial. You can use holy power. Your crusader strike generates holy power. And your word of glory can spend it. So is that pretty much what word of glory is for? So that generates... Okay, so crusader strike generates one charge of holy power. Now I don't know if it's sort of like a cooldown system where you can only have one holy power or two or three holy power for certain times. It might go off after about 10 seconds, or it might just stay there and hang around for a while until I use it, because it's like that. But who knows? I don't think... Shall I put it on F? I'm actually thinking of put it on the down... Yeah, I'll put it on the down mouse wheel thing. So we're completing our Mazoranchi quest, and we'll get some hand grips. Some nummy hand grips. And that's all the quests for him. What quest we got to do? The Thunderhorn Totem. And I think there was a quest for someone else over here. I think. I hope. I dread. Yeah, there we go. Mool or Rule Eagle Talon. Hello, Rule Eagle Talon. What have you got to bring us? Bring 8 Wind Fury Talons to Rule Eagle Talon at Bloodhoof Village. That's ironic. The Talon wants talons. So, let's get the totem, the talons even, and then we'll go... In fact, we can get the Stalker Claws and Cougar Claws on the way and way back, because I think they like to loiter, these beasts of dreaded fury. Another thing I have to point out is the spells. Instead of getting ranks of spells every now and again, every time you level up, that spell will increase by, say, 1 point or 2 points, whatever sort of range the spell is. So say you've got a healing spell and that heals for 80 per charge. When I level up, that might be 81, and so forth until level 85. And now the Cataclysm is officially out. I'm going to get to 85. So forget 80. 80 sucks. 85 is where I'm going to go. Yeah. I'm afraid not going to do the thing at level... If you play WoW, you've played WoW before, you'll know that at level 68, you usually go to Northrend. But now they've changed all that. Instead, you get a bonus of EXP, say 10% for each of the zones. So at level 1 to 60, you get 10%... No, you get normal amount 1 to 60. So that's leveling Mulgore, Barons, wherever. And then at level 60, you go to Outland instead of level 58. Because at level 60, am I going? Yeah, I'm going in the right direction. This is where we're going! Scary Egg Place. Yes. What was I talking about? Oh, god damn you, memory. But, yeah. At level 60, you go to Outland because you've got an EXP boost. What I'll do is I'll put a link in the description if you'd like to know more about this EXP change. I wouldn't worry about it so much if you're not playing well, because... Oh my god, the lag. The impending lag. The reason I've got lag is because... Well, actually, it's not bad. 54 latency. My download's 100% complete. That's weird, because the new download system's just plain weird. You can... When you start up the game, it'll come up with a launcher, and that launcher's basically, is my holy power. Is that another bag? No, okay, that's good. When you start up WoW, it'll come up with a launcher, and that launcher basically means how much you've got to download. So instead of waiting for the game to download, you can just play, and it'll download Yeah, you can play while the game's downloading. So you download a bit, then you play while it's downloading. But when I start World of Warcraft, it's weird because it's at like 80%. But as soon as I log on, oh look, it's at 100%. Weird. Oh, and we're at full holy power. You know what that means? We can do a portal there and then heal ourselves. I don't know what the charges mean, but I guess we'll find out. I think that's 3 charges. Is it? I don't even know. If you can tell how many charges that is, please write in the comments below and I'll give you a shout out, just because I'm like that. I want to do more events, sort of with comments and random stuff, and give you rewards, because, hey, it's a sort of like a TV channel, YouTube. Problem is, there's so many. It'd be weird if it was on television. More lag! Oh no! At least the game doesn't crash on me, because that would really suck. And we're one-shotting these monsters. Okay, we're out of talons. Now we can go to the Thunderhorn Totem of Doom. That's right. Oh my god, two level 5 prairie dogs. Don't you threatening growl me! Avoid red mobs. Not good. Ooh, a lonely Kodo. You know what that means? I'm gonna kill it. You know why? Because I can. Ooh, a Kodo matriarch. I could actually die doing this, but... meh. What you gonna do about it, Mr. Kodo? Let me get my holy power up. Alright, let's do this. Oh crap, they're all attacking me. Holy power. Let's continue. EXP for the win. Oh god. Please don't kill me. Oh no. It's all going haywire. Wow, this is exciting. I haven't equipped my hand grips. But I killed all the Kodos! Yes, that's where I'm just that pro. So let's loot their lonely corpses that wither in the dusky plains of Azeroth. Let's say you kill a group of Kodos. The element of surprise. But then again, if I saw a massive cowman walking down the street with a huge sledgehammer and spiky shoulder guards, I'd be pretty wary myself. A gazelle. I'm gonna hug it because I can. I'm gonna leave it alone. I'm not that ruthless. Kill a lonely gazelle. I might actually change the settings so it doesn't show up with one holy power. Usually I just have mana or I just have health gains. You can set it in the interface option. Like EXP, I think you can actually disable that as well when the message pops up. So I might disable Holy Power, I haven't decided yet. So, with the Crusader Strike, it's meant to... See, that generates 3 Holy Power, but I don't get it because Crusader Strike's only meant to generate 1. And I'm killing all the wrong things for some reason. Just grinding away. Well, I want to get to level 10 this video. So yeah. That's pretty much it. Hello, Flatland Cooler. I still don't know why it generates 3. More Kodos! I'm gonna leave these ones alone because that battle was pretty epic as it is. Damn you, pop-ups! You gotta hate them. Especially Skype messages. If you ever play a game on full screen mode, never open a Windows Messenger. Whatever it is, or any messenger. That means Skype, Windows Live Messenger, Hotmail, whatever. It's just really annoying when you're playing a game and it pops up. And if you're on full screen mode, it doesn't matter. It's gonna minimize. And if you've got a slow computer, you know what that means. 3 minutes. That's right. 3 whole minutes of waiting for that goddamn game to minimize, and then you've got to just close the message, and then you've got to open the game, and then you've got to close the game, and then you've got to read the messages. And then you find out that your wife's cheating on you. Ha! I laugh at those fools. We need 3 Stalker Claws. Are these stalkers? No, they're cougars. These are stalkers. Yes. Haha, I'm gonna sneak up on you. Sneak. I am just that pro. It doesn't really look like I'm sneaking. Just casually walking up to it and then... Die! 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 What am I talking about? I have no idea. And yet, I'm still talking! I might as well just let you talk! Yes, you can commentate on my videos! See how you feel! One more stalker. I might not just select that one. I might be just completely weird and... I'm gonna go for that one, yeah. I don't like that one. Kill everything in my path. With my epic revolving mace. It's probably my favorite heirloom weapon, to be honest. Because it moves. I've never really seen that with... I mean, you've got the staff. And that has sort of a spinny skull thing. I still haven't equipped my handguards. There we go. Wow, look at that! Look at these brown mitts of glorified justice. Oh my goodness. With my three talony fingers. Wow. I don't get what the key's for in the mace. Maybe it's to turn it on, but... Hey, when you got me, you don't need turned on. Dudung-dung-ch. I do hope we level. 750, I need 1,995 experience. I'm not gonna get there. Shame! Okay, I think, yeah, the holy power goes off after a while. Which is cool. I think it's overpowered in PvP though, because I've faced a lot of paladins on my shaman, my rogue, all my characters, and I can never seem to beat them now. Tell me what you think in the comments, why not? I might even give you a shout out, because I can. Might just do a shout out fest next video. Hello again, Mole Thunderhorn. What dost thou bring me? Oh, nothing. Just EXP. And I am now honored with Thunderbluff. I have created the totem. You, Polaris, must cleanse the well. Ooh, how scary. Oh, I didn't read the quest. Oh, no. Use the Thunderhorn cleansing totem at the Thunderhorn water well. Okay, and where be thy well? Thy well of victory. Okay, so the well's over here. And I only need to go up here to explore the whole of Morgor. Wow. No items? Are you serious? Are you serious? Are you serious? If only John the Walrus was here, I'd be so happy. Let's go cleanse a well. Be cool if I got a title like Polaris the Well Cleanser. And there'd be me fighting Deathwing, who happens to have 838 million health. Or if I'm wrong, it's 832 million health. Which sucks, because that's a lot of health. I mean, a lot. What am I talking about? Ooh, another quest! Ahab Wheathoof. Does everything end in horn, hoof, and stalker, and weird names? Anyway. Ahab Wheathoof at Bloodhoof Village in Morgor wants you to feed his prized puppy, Carl the Frenzied. Feed Carl tender strider meat and return to Ahab Wheathoof. Have we got any tender strider meat? I don't think we have. We've got stringy wolf meat, Kodo meat, squishy cud. What the hell is that? No, doesn't seem like, so let's kill a plane strider. A lonely plane strider, there's one! Let me lick it. Test that it's good meek. Meat even. Hello, Mr. Plane Strider. You've just met your doom! Ha 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 ha! And I'm missing. That's not good. He knows my weakness. Don't bite me in the groin, for it will duplicate. So there's our 10 Strider meat. We can put that on our bar. Let's put it on R. I usually put my most used spells on R, which is fine with me. So now we've got to find Kyle the Frenzied, and then we can level up. And that'll be the end of the video, sadly. Oh, Kyle! Where are you? I'm not going to kill you. There you are. Come back! No! I'm suddenly speaking Scottish. For some reason. That's probably the worst Scottish accent I've ever heard, Popress. Oh god, can I just put it down? No. It's got a range? How does Tender Strider meat have a range? I mean, it's not like... I mean, you can throw it within a certain distance, but... Oh my god, this is really one frenzied puppy. Okay, I think I've cornered him. He's running straight towards me! There we go. And I've frozen. Oh, there we go. Kyle the Frenzied howls in delight at sight of his lunch, and then he begins to eat it. So I can't sort of sit on... I'm riding the great... Oh, no, no, that is so wrong on so many levels. Don't do that. In fact... Oh, he's run off. Okay, let's hand it in, level up, and finish the video. Then I've got to edit, render, and upload it. But you wouldn't know that because you're watching it now! Haha! That's gonna be so cool when we're like level 20 and we've got an epic Kodo to ride on. As a paladin, you don't have to buy a Kodo, you get to summon one. Believe you me, the Kodos in Cataclysm and the Tauren paladin summon are so effing epic. You have no idea. Or you might, I mean, you might even have a Tauren paladin. I know some of my subscribers have. And I might just track them down and kill them. No, seriously. I'm a good guy. What do you mean? I've already fed your dog. What are you talking about? This is a conspiracy. Oh my god. We have got our first talent point. So, let's have a look. We've got Holy. And we get Holy Shock with that. Bless the Holy Target with Holy Energy. Blah, blah, blah. You can read the rest. Just pause the video. Increase your effectiveness with your healing spells. And 50% of your mana regeneration from spirit to continue while in combat. And this is the healing spec. These little sort of circular things. One's a cross, one's a shield, one's a DPS. Or a sword even. That means healer, tank, and DPS. Now, the most common one for paladins is retribution. Now, we get Templar's Verdict, an instant weapon attack that causes a percentage of weapon damage, consumes all charges of holy power to increase damage dealt. Fair enough. And we get two-handed weapon specializations, which is gonna pwn. Sheath of Light. And Judgment of the Bold. So let's go Retribution. Oh, I haven't showed the protection. Avenger's Shield. Hurls a holy shield at the enemy, dealing 153 holy damaging. 153 holy damage. What am I on? I mean, seriously. Are you serious? Silencing and interrupting spellcasting for 3 seconds, and then jumping to additional nearby targets. This is the most effective tanking sort of pulling thing that ranged paladin tanks have. But I'm not going to be a tank because I don't even have a shield, so screw it. Pause the video and read that if you want. I really can't do that because I'm blind and I'm playing this with guidance of a guide dog who plays WoW regularly. So yeah. So let's go Retribution, and we get Improved Judgment, Crusade, and Eye for an Eye. So pause it now if you want to read that. Pause it now if you want to read that. And pause it now if you want to read that. Now I'm going to go with Crusade, which increases the damage of your Crusader Strike, Hammer of Righteousness, and Templar's Verdict by 10%. Let's learn it. There we go, we got a new spell, so let's put it on our bars. It's already on our bars, so there we go. And do that, and do that, and then we go. So, we're going to jump off the bridge. Whee! Ooh, we're underwater, that's not good. Get out of the... What is with me? There we go. Right, next time... Oh, nice reeds. Hello, reeds. Look at me, all serious. Next time on Let's Play World of Warcraft, we might just get to level 11 if we're pro enough. But that's the question, are we pro enough? So, take care and stay tuned next time.